Welcome to the Azure AD B2C Architecture Deep Dive Series. I am Jaz Suri. I am a Program Manager in the Azure AD Engineering Team here at Microsoft.
I am Mukunda Murthy. I am also a Program Manager in the Azure AD Engineering Team. Both Jaz and I are part of Customer Experience Program.
We receive a lot of questions about how Azure AD B2C works under the hood. Azure AD B2C provides business-to-customer identity as a service. In this video series, we will cover how you can onboard users to your applications using a self-service signup experience and go through how a typical sign-in works. To get started, what options do users have to sign up?
To provide online services to your customers, it is common for users to sign up using their personal email addresses, phone numbers, federated or social identities. In this video, let's look at signing up using an email address. Let me explain the signup flow. In Azure AD B2C, most common identity tasks are available through predefined and easily configurable policies called user flows. Now, if you want a highly customizable experience, you can use custom policies. In both cases, the user flow and the custom policies define the steps of the user experience, as well as the interactions between Azure AD B2C and various components. Your application can call one or more policies depending on whether the user would like to sign up, sign in, reset their passwords, or do something else. As an initial step, the B2C provider registers their application in the directory and publishes the endpoints. The registered application triggers the signup user flow by using a standard OpenID Connect authentication request that includes a policy parameter in the URL specific to signup. I will introduce a few important B2C components. In B2C, the user flow or custom policy is processed by Identity Experience Framework Policy Engine, or Policy Engine in short. The Policy Engine looks inside the policy to determine what steps need to be executed and in what order. The core store is where B2C stores the user objects, and the authentication services component uses the core store to validate credentials. The flow begins when you click to sign up from your application. The authentication request includes your B2C policy ID in the URL. The request reaches an endpoint called yourtenantname.b2clogin.com. The policy engine validates the OpenID Connect request by comparing its parameters to the application registration stored in the core store. The policy engine executes the policy. Behind the scenes, policies are stored in Azure Blob Store, partitioned by tenant. The policy engine evaluates the policy specified in the URL into memory and then executes its steps sequentially, first of which will be to display the signup form. B2C renders the necessary elements into the div container with the ID API. To load branded pages, you can target the div container with your custom HTML. The JavaScript on client browser will pull the custom HTML from your HTML storage and merges it with the HTML rendered to the browser from the policy engine. You have options to store the HTML content in an Azure blob, CDN, or anywhere that suits your business needs. We recommend using a CDN because it is faster for a better user experience. You can then enter your email to begin the registration. By default, you will be asked to validate your email, but this is optional. If email validation is required, the policy engine informs the self-service password reset service to issue a one-time passcode, which will be sent to your inbox. You can then enter and verify your one-time passcode. You now enter your new password for your account. As you submit the signup form, the policy engine makes a Graph API call to write your account information into the core store. Now you are onboarded with an account into the application. The policy engine completes the journey by redirecting the user to the application with a token. This response is a JSON web token. You are now logged in. If the initial authentication request were to be SAML, then a SAML assertion will be issued in the response to the application. That completes the user's sign up.
Good. Now that I've been onboarded through the signup flow, what does my sign-in experience look like?
Okay. Let me explain the steps you will be taking during a typical sign-in. Just like the signup flow we saw before, the registered application triggers the sign-in user flow by using a standard OpenID Connect authentication request. The request has to contain the policy AD parameter of the sign-in policy. The policy engine validates the OpenID Connect request. It does this by checking the details held in the application registration in the core store. The policy engine evaluates the policy specified in the URL into memory and then sequentially executes the steps. Like the signup flow, B2C renders the necessary elements into the div container with the ID API. To load branded pages, JavaScript on the client browser pulls the custom HTML from your HTML storage and merges it with the HTML rendered to your browser from the policy engine. You can then enter your email and password and click sign in. The policy engine then makes a resource owner password credential request to the authentication service. This is an API-based OpenID Connect request. Note that this ROPC call is internal to the B2C backend environment. The authentication service validates the credentials against the core store. Upon validation, the authentication service issues an Azure AD token to the policy engine. The policy engine validates the Azure AD token and extracts the claims such as user's object ID. If multi-factor authentication is required, the policy engine challenges you through the Azure MFA service. If you haven't provided a phone number earlier, we will ask you for one. Otherwise, we will verify you using the phone number we already have. Finally, the policy engine completes the user journey and issues an Azure AD B2C token to your application. Note the difference here. The policy engine issues a B2C token even though it receives an Azure AD token from the authentication service. The Azure AD token is not exposed to the application. Also, the policy engine drops a cookie for single sign-on purposes on the b2clogin.com domain. And as a final step, you are redirected to the application. And that completes the sign-in flow.
Great, here are my takeaways. Azure AD B2C provides built-in user flows for commonly used experiences such as sign-up, sign-in, and password reset. We just saw the flows for sign-up and sign-in. The end user experience is important to the users. That's why we allow a sign-up experience to onboard users through their personal email, federated social ID, or a combination. You can design authentication experiences that are fully branded such that users feel familiar with your service. A CDN is the preferred method for storing HTML content, as it is more performant and provides a better user experience. Users can enroll and sign in securely with Azure Multi-Factor Authentication. We hope you find this video useful. Make sure you tune in to the rest of the Azure AD B2C Architecture Deep Dive series.